Welcome to a video on revenue, cost, profit, and finding a break-even quantity. First, before we get started on our problem here, which deals with a given cost function and revenue function and finding a profit function, let's just do a quick review on what those functions represent. So, the revenue function is going to give you a function that tells you the money that's received from the sale of your goods. A cost function is going to tell you how much it costs to produce that good. And then for profit, this is what we're going to be needing, especially today, is we find our profit function by the revenue, subtract the cost function. Then to find a break-even point, the breaking even is the amount of sales that you need to sell to cover all your total costs. So this is a quantity, and we find it by setting the profit equal to zero. You can also find it by setting the revenue equal to cost, but we'll do it by setting the profit equal to zero. Okay, so back to our problem. So it gives us a total cost for selling dog treats, and it gives us a revenue. So we're going to find a profit function. So the profit function is going to be found by taking our revenue function, subtracting our cost function. So that's going to be our negative 2x squared plus our 316x. And subtracting, don't forget parentheses, 6x plus 10,908. Alright, so distributing the negative, we're going to come up with a profit function, which is negative 2x squared, 316x, distribute the negative, minus 6x, minus 10,908. So here's our simplified profit function. If we combine these two like terms here, we're going to end up with negative 2x squared plus 310x minus 10908. Okay, here's our profit function. All right, first part done. Now it would like us to find what quantity is the smallest break-even point. So again, breaking even is when your profit equals zero. So we're going to take our profit function and set it equal to zero. So we're going to have negative 2x squared. We have our 310x minus 10,908. Set it equal to zero. And then we have to solve for x. Now we can do this several ways. We could factor, try factoring, or we could jump right into the quadratic formula. But before you do either of those, I recommend cleaning this up a little bit, because there is a common factor with all these terms. We could actually divide out both sides by negative 2, and that'll make our numbers smaller. It'll make it easier to attempt to factor, or easier to use a quadratic formula, whichever you end up deciding to try. All right, so if we divide here by the negative 2, we end up with this. Now remember, negative divided by negative is a positive. So we get 54, and 0 divided by negative 2 is still 0. All right, so now it is easier to factor if we want to try factoring. If you're not feeling real confident with those big numbers in there, then we could just jump into the quadratic formula. So if we do that, the quadratic formula we're going to use, A is 1, B is negative 155, and the C is 54, and let me remind you of our quadratic formula, which is negative b plus or minus square root b squared minus 4ac, and the whole thing divided by 2a. So we're going to plug our numbers into this formula, and out should pop our x values. All right, so x is going to equal negative b, so that's going to be a negative 155, plus or minus the square root, b squared, negative 155 squared, minus 4 times a times c. Now the other option I didn't mention is a lot of the scientific calculators these days have a pre-programmed quadratic formula already in them, and that you could use as well to get to this solution much quicker. All right, but carrying on with this, we're going to end up with a positive 155. And then combining all those terms in that square root, squaring, subtracting, we end up with a value of 2209. Now try that on your calculator, make sure I'm correct there. All divided by 2. Alright, and there is a nice square root of 2209. So 155 plus and minus, we get a 47, all divided by 2. So I'm going to keep going. We're going to get two answers, and it does ask for the smallest break-even point. So keep that in mind. I'm only going to give one of these answers. So I have 155 plus 47 over 2. That'll give us one value. And the other value, which should be the smaller one, since it's 155 minus 47 over 2, should give us the other. So cleaning this up, 155, if you add 47, you get 202. And that divided by 2 gives you 101. The other, if we take 155 and subtract 47, we get 108. And when we divide that by 2, we get 54. Now 54 is obviously smaller than 101, so 54 is the smallest break-even point. So let me answer their question. Now remember, 54 is an x value. This is a quantity, and if you recall our problem, the x values were dog treats. So I'm going to say that 54 boxes of dog treats must be sold to break even. So we've got our break-even quantity, and we used it, and we found that by finding our profit function. All right, well, I hope this has been helpful.